here, ladies and gentlemen, Jim Ross and Magnum TA in World Championship Wrestling. Jim Cornette's Midnight Express against the awesomely strong team of the Terminator and Bobby Eaton with a tremendous neckbreaker there, Magnum. And guess who's back?
Absolutely. These men, Paulie Dangerously and his Midnight Express, aren't going to let this thing lie. They definitely think they're going to put this man away.
I'll tell you one thing. They've been warned by the NWA board. Any outbursts in this studio, and they're through here.
They come out here wanting to taunt me about what February 20 is going to look like. February 20 is going to look like these two hood-headed clowns laying on the floor. That's going to be Condrey and Rose. And Dangerously, you're still mine. If I ain't got what it takes in me to take you out, I'd rather be washing dishes at Denny's.
Midnight Express with a great team move here, fans, and they have made very short work of an awesomely strong team, the Terminators, Cornette's Midnight Express, with a victory here on World Championship Wrestling. We'll take another look at it, Magnum, here very quickly.
Jim Ross, if there's a weak link in this team, it's certainly not Stan or Bobby, either one. They got this man up in the air, double team and planted.
Tremendous move by the Midnight Express fans. When we come back in just a moment, Magnum TA will be joined by the Total Package Lex Luger, and we'll be back with that very important interview right after you see this.
Total Package is a man certainly used to being in the hot seat, so I'm going to put you in the hot seat right now and ask you a few questions. You know, Ric Flair has gone on record as saying he's never going to wrestle the Total Package again, but I happen to know that you've got the U.S. heavyweight title really in your sights now. So if, by chance, the U.S. title around your waist, how can he help but recognize the number one contender, the U.S. heavyweight champion, as a title competitor?
That's exactly how I see it, Magnum. It's a very astute observation. You see, Ric Flair, I've had a lot of legal obstacles in my way since our last match. You won't give me a rematch. Apparently, you have a select list of who you wrestle and who you won't. Well, I know one thing. He's got a big match coming up with Ricky Steamboat. And I know if he becomes champion, I know he has every attribute necessary to become the next World Heavyweight Champion. I won't have to be in a not wrestle list. He'll wrestle everybody, Flair. That's something you're not doing right now. So if I do beat Barry Windham on February 20th, as U.S. title holder, automatically does make me the number one contender to the World's title.
Well, there's one more thing you've got to realize. You've got to beat the man. You've got to beat Windham. How can you defense the superplex, the lariat, and the claw?
Well, Barry has a lot of offensive weapons. I just saw a very impressive display by him. But one thing's for sure, I've become a student of wrestling. I've watched him on film many, many times. I'm prepared for as much as I ever have been. And what I'm going to do is wrestle the match of my life and hopefully become the winner.
Thank you very much, Lex, for your time. We've got a big match coming up here in the ring, a workout of sorts, Jim Ross.
We certainly do, Magnum fans. Ricky the Dragon.